so you're a nine holer.
Yeah.
A few times a week, mostly with friends.
Yeah.
No competitive.
No.
Okay. Would you maybe think about getting more into it?
Yeah.
A little more competitive.
Yeah, I need to get better first.
Okay. Do you have a handicap?
No.
Okay. So do you keep score when you play?
I played three times. I've kept score twice.
Okay. So most of the time you do.
Yeah. So we'll check that and see. There may be a little weight and length issue there.
Okay.
And those are addressable, but maybe if you get into it a little bit more this summer, I would suggest it would be you go get fitted. You know
okay.
what I mean? So there's nothing to replace getting fitted rather than just buying something off the rack. There's a lot of information out there, and in 20 years,
from the fairway, hitting a second shot with a fairway.
Yes, I'm very consistent slicing.
Okay. All right. So we'll do a warm up. We'll warm up with an iron, and then we'll address that three wood. We'll try and establish some parameters, and you can tell me I can hit in that parameter. I can, and we'll
okay.
try and narrow it down and see if we can get you where you can keep it in the fairway. And we'll get when we get to the three wood. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like sometimes,
I do.
Yeah. Okay, so the first one, we're gonna take a club and we're gonna have hands on either side and put it behind our back. And we're gonna get in our setup and our posture. So we're gonna bend at the hips a little bit. And this will help with your lower back, the rotation. And we just wanna kind of rotate to your limit, back and forth. And we're gonna do 10 on each side. Feel your back?
Yeah.
Okay. We're gonna do one similar setup, but we're gonna have a club in front of us, and you're gonna kind of bicycle with your arms, and this is to warm up your shoulders.
Okay.
Okay. So we're just gonna go like this forward. Another one I like to do is a really simple stretch, but I feel like it really stretches out your back and your legs. It's just with your shoulder width apart, just let your back and kind of do a toe touch and let this weight of this club pull you down. And we're going to try and hold it for 30 seconds. perfect. That's a perfect thing to warm up and start. I'm just going to observe. I'm going to watch you from the side and from behind and try and see what your motion is. Physical issues with motion, any surgeries recently, anything to inhibit you today?
Nothing recent. I have a bad ACL patella break, and it gets sore sometimes.
Is it? How recent?
97.
Okay. Have you had any issues when you play golf with it?
If I overdo it, it'll get sore.
Okay.
I think it's just from the twisting, because it's not
okay.
What I usually do.
Well, let me know if anything affects that, and we'll avoid anything that affects it. Let's put it that way. Do those feel okay as far as being loosened?
Yeah.
Okay. As far as a pattern, is this a similar inconsistency?
No, I just don't feel like warmed up.
Okay, you don't feel completely warmed up. Okay. That was good contact.
Waiting for the red flag, though.
Okay, all right. But it was right at your target. And did you feel like you adjusted yourself there?
What do you mean?
Right before you hit, did you adjust your aim?
Yeah.
Yeah, you did. Okay. So that the one previous that was hit good was just, you may have been aimed over there.
I may have. I
okay.
Couldn't even tell you.
Okay.
Better.
Okay.
Yeah.
on a normal round, if you hit it 5 times, how many times would you keep it in that fairway?
Probably one.
Okay.
One or two. Yeah.
So with changing nothing, just observing, we hit 2 in the fairway, but 1 you almost don't count that because you hit it poorly.
Right.
Okay, so 3 out of the 5 did not stay in our fairway. And of those 3 out of the 5, how many do you think you hit solidly?
Probably 2.
Okay. Alright. So if we want to improve, I mean, would you be happy if it got to let's do 6 and if we got to 3 out of 6?
Yeah, that would be great.
That would be a huge improvement, right? Okay. All right. So the first thing I noticed is that you have a lot of foot action, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
So, and you have longer clubs, which has a tendency to put you further away from the ball. When that happens, it's really, with the foot action, it's really hard to maintain that relationship to the ball that you've established at setup.
Right.
Right? So if I'm back and I have a huge foot, there's a lot of moving parts.
Yeah.
So if we can calm down that foot, it can help with the consistency. Right? And we notice that most of those went to the right. So that means that club face is open.
Okay.
Have you played any other sports growing up?
That affects the softball, yeah.
Softball?
Yeah.
Okay, so softball is that's kind of a baseball-softball move, right?
Yeah,
like when you're hitting,
you
step and you move in, right?
Yep.
So that may be both of those things combined,
yeah.
Is I'm reaching for the ball because I know I'm going to step and move in.
Right.
So what we want to establish is we want to establish this relationship and maintain it, not have that move
in,
and not have that step. Okay?
Yeah.
So the first thing I would do to get closer is try and choke down so that getting closer doesn't feel...
Just shorten the club?
Yeah, just shorten it a little bit. It doesn't have to be that much. Maybe right in there.
Okay.
So you feel like you can be closer.
Okay, I usually grab it right about there.
Okay, so just give yourself... Yeah, so you can feel... So it's not like really cramped in there.
Yeah.
All right? And see if we can feel like our feet stay connected to the ground.
Uh-huh.
All right?
Yeah.
It still went right, but it was hit solid.
Yep.
Correct? Okay. Yeah. All
right. Well, I'm wondering if I'm aiming that way, or is it just going?
No, I would say that they might be a little not lined up well. That's why I'm up. Let me watch one back here. So that's one. And it was hit well, but
not in.
So that little bit of closeness didn't fix that.
No, but
right,
I hit them two solid in a row.
I was setting up this, and I want you to take that and put it more at an angle to kind of immobilize this left foot so you don't use it so much.
Set up an internal?
Yes. You want to do the setup first.
Okay, so here?
Yep. Now turn it in just slightly. There you go. And I'll see how this feels as far as immobilizing. It definitely immobilized you, right?
Yeah, totally awkward.
Okay. How was that in your knee? Was that okay in your knee?
Yeah.
It's okay in your knee, okay. let's try one more with that drill. So we've set up regular. You're still gripped down on it, correct?
Yep.
Okay. Just turn it a little, yep. All right, we got the right out of it. Both of them, neither one of those.
Oh yeah, they both hooked.
They both went left, all right. So let's try one regular and see if that has helped you.
Nope, don't turn the foot in.
Don't turn the foot in, let's do a regular setup and see if it helps you minimize that foot action. Did you feel your foot?
I felt it.
We did three with the drill and three without, so. No, we did two with the drill and four without. We hit three of them super solid. We hit one of those threes was dead perfect, better trajectory right in the middle.
Right.
And the two with the drill took the right out of it.
Right, yeah.
So, with that foot in, do you feel a difference?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I can't as much.
It's a big change from what you do. I mean, to keep that, your foot is moving. Yeah,
oh,
but
okay.
That's not abnormal for softball, right?
No.
Right, okay.
It's staying on the ground doesn't do that in softball.
You don't do that in softball.
No.
And how long did you play softball?
Too many.
It seems like too many now because of golf.
Yeah.
But. You don't want to get too entrenched in that drill,
right?
Thank you. no drill. Okay, so you just want to do it regular, just try and transfer that sensation of that left side not being as abrupt a motion. This is the feel I need to have. That needs to be calmer. Mm-hmm. This needs to stop lifting, right? Because it moves everything.
Yes.
It affects your whole level of the swing, right? And then that affects, you know, hitting it high, hitting it low, hitting it right, hitting it left. It affects that hook thing dramatically, right? If you get a chance, again, instead of just